In this video, revealing a step-by-step tutorial on how to make passive income online and how complete beginners earning $100 to $700 a day with no experience. More of that after the intro. Hey guys, Mike Vasile here. Welcome to this video. Before we actually begin, I remind you that HubSpot have opened up for this week's free workshop where it's the fastest and easiest way to make money online. Sign up for it in the link below. We got a 62-year-old woman that went from zero to 160 grand profit in 90 days. Check it out now. All right, guys, so check this out. I want to break down my passive income machine that generates me literally in the past 365 days, got me from $7 a day in passive income to $300 in passive income a day, to the point where now, like, if you look in the past 28 days, it's doing about like $1,300 a day in passive income, as well as another online business that generates in the past 30 days about $61,000 net in passive income. And the craziest thing is in the past 7 days, it's generated about like $13,000 net in passive income. But here's the thing, when most people see this, like, oh my God, that can never be me, Mike. I'm not smart enough. I'm not good looking enough. I'm not confident enough. And the thing about this is what prevents most people from getting started. Because I remember when I was a broke college student, suddenly become a dentist, to literally trade my time away for money, I never thought that any of this was actually possible. You know, growing up, you know, my parents came from the Philippines to America, had me and my sister, and my entire life, the only way that I thought to make money was seeing the way they worked, and they're like, oh, if we want to make more money, we have to trade more time for our money. Which is why I saw them work like 8 hours a day to 15 hours a day as a nurse and an engineer, blood, sweat, and tears, to just make enough to provide for me and my sister. Which is why when I got older, I thought, oh, to make passive income, I have to just work harder. But little did I know that I'm literally trading away hours of my life, the precious hours that I cannot get back, for money that I'm gonna spend to impress people that I don't even like or care about, right? It just did not make any sense. So I started thinking, okay, if I become a dentist, you know, I have to, you know, essentially borrow a bunch of money to go to college, to then get a job, so that maybe when I'm 40 and 50, pay the money back that I initially borrowed to get this job. It didn't make any sense. So I started thinking, what are ways that I can make passive income where I can literally make money when I sleep, where I don't have to trade my time for money, where I could spend it, you know, finish paying off my credit card debt or my student loan debt or helping my mom and dad, and to begin traveling and interviewing more awesome people, right? That's what I wanted, and that's when all of these things started happening. When I created that, and I started interviewing all these successful people from all around the world, like this 11-year-old girl, they turned on $30 million, and this guy that makes $1 million per month profit. There was things that the ultra successful people were doing that were making really strong passive income that most people don't teach you this in college. And that's really breaks down to just four things. So we're gonna break down all the four things. When it comes to making money in passive income, you really just need four things. And that's creating traffic, capturing leads, converting sales, and delivering the offer. If you master that and you outsource all of that, passive income can happen a lot faster. And if you don't know exactly what these mean, don't worry, I'm gonna explain it. So the first thing is creating traffic. What does that mean? Well, traffic in the internet world is eyeballs to where people are going. Like, where are people hanging out? Like, you know, the best trafficked places are where McDonald's go, because then they know that the more people that drive in front of their McDonald's, the more money they can make. So location is everything. It's the exact same thing with the online virtual scape. Your problem though is, how can you get a piece of digital real estate to go ahead and begin with? That's why, for example, I created my blog, because how I create traffic is by sending a lot of people to my blog and my website, which will potentially turn into money, right? And how I create traffic is creating content that people are searching for on search engines and putting it on my Pinterest account, which you can see, you know, we're getting about like 98,000 monthly views, as well as my YouTube channel, which, because of my YouTube channel, we literally went, like I said, from like $7 a day in the past 365 days to now averaging like $1,000 a day, which is like ridiculous, right? And when it comes to creating traffic, it's very simple. What are people searching for that are problem-based, and how can I get in front of them? So for example, for the sake of the argument, let's say I wanted to sell, for example, an e-commerce educational product. I'll literally go to search, type in all pins, and type in how to, let me just do e-commerce business. And then I'm gonna wait what actually pops up, because what will actually pop up are all of these things that people are searching for. So e-commerce business ideas, e-commerce plan, e-commerce name ideas, e-commerce model. Meaning, if I create content on this, the odds of me getting found by people that have no idea who I am are a lot higher. I can own that piece of digital real estate where now people are driving in front of that keyword every single day. If I put an offer in front of there, that I don't even have to create the offer, right? I could go ahead and make passive income by just being kind of like the real estate keeper in the virtual world. It's the exact same thing with, for example, YouTube, right? I could type in, for example, e-commerce, business, and all of these things pop up. These are, just think about all of these are like, you know, street names. So it's like, you know, Jefferson Street, Thomas Street, Wall Street, Main Street, all of these things are streets. And the more busy it is, the more potential it is for you to go ahead and make money in terms of passive income with this real estate analogy, right? So if I create content about this on my website, on my blog, on whatever, people are gonna find me. And that's essentially how I started creating initial traffic. And then I started even renting that space out to other advertisers to go ahead and rent my virtual land. And you could see that that's exactly why when I figured this out, it went from like $300 a day. And I was like, oh wow, this works. People really like this virtual real estate thing. Then $800 a day, then $1,000 a day. And remember, this was all within 365 days. So that's essentially how I create traffic. I focus all of it on my blog. I create, like I put it also on Pinterest. You can see we're getting traffic to our website. Like we're getting 48 clicks here and it's simple. We just use Canva and it's free to use Canva. We just use like these ugly images because for some reason, ugly images work really well compared to like high level Instagram quality images on Pinterest or on Instagram. And then we also create content about it, you know, on YouTube, right? And that's how people start finding us. Because when we rank for these keywords, guess what? It's passively people driving in front of our store every single day, driving in front of Main Street, in front of Wall Street, in front of the e-commerce business street, or in front of like the e-commerce business idea street, right? So many people are driving by. So that's the first level of passive income. Now people are in front all the time. They're constantly coming in every single day. That leads us to the second step, which is capturing leads. That's why on my blog and my website, we grab people's email addresses. Because when we capture people's email addresses, we could essentially get them into our entire sales process. We could have them start talking to all of our salespeople that are in the back end that are literally not even salespeople. They're like mini robots to go ahead and earn money. Our salespeople are essentially little emails that we write on the back end to go ahead and promote products in like a 30-day sequence. So literally when people come in and we capture the lead, we send them emails promoting stories and content and value and whatnot. And that's what builds a relationship, okay? So when you capture the lead or the email, you get to build a relationship with people. Think about you going and walking into the store, right? Your own local butcher. Oh, hey, Tom, how's it going? Nice seeing you again, right? Like the more relationship you build with the local businesses, the more likely you're able to go back in. It's like why you go to the same barber all the time or the same salon shop, because you're building a relationship. That's what happens when you capture someone's email address when you build a website and a blog. Which is why we talk more about that in the 5-day bootcamp below, right? Essentially, that's what we do. You know, we send them value, we sell them free courses, we sell them trainings and whatnot, and other video trainings all through here. Which leads me to the third step, and that's converting the sale, right? How do you convert the sale? What's multiple ways. Email is a big one because of like, you don't have to show your face on camera. You can just write things. You can tell really cool stories. Like here, I tell a story about how me and my sister quit our job, started traveling, living in Bali, Thailand, Philippines, Greece, Portugal, Spain, Peru, Vietnam, France, and how we started interviewing all these multimillionaires that live here in Bali, like this guy that makes $1 million per month profit. We're even interviewing this girl who was 11 and turned down $30 million, right? So we just started building relationships, sending them podcasts and whatnot. And then to convert the sale, sometimes what we do is we get other people to convert the sale for us. Like for example, if you sign up for a free ClickBank account, which is where we make a good amount of money, where in the past 30 days, we've netted about, once this actually loads, $61,000 net. And even like in the past 7 days, like you said, like today we made $1,900 for a product that I did not have to create, which is why it's passive income, right? We literally get some other people to go ahead and deliver the product themselves and do the selling for us. You can see we can get upwards to $595 per commission, right? And essentially what it is when you do this is they will literally give you a sales template where this guy who's made millions of dollars will not only teach for you so you don't have to be the expert, but they'll do the selling for you. And this is literally what I do. I find products that I really vibe with that are also listed either privately or publicly on ClickBank, and I go ahead and promote it. That's why, you know, for the lowest days we'll pull in like $568, but for the highest days, you know, like we'll pull in $1,900, like for example today, or $1,400 the day before, right? And pulling in $61,000 net. The craziest thing is for people that do this method, since they don't have to do the selling, it's even more passive because it's you're leveraging someone else's time instead of your own. And last but not least is delivering the value in the product that they're buying, okay? Because that's essentially what will create the passive income or not. Back in the day, I would be the one that would, for example, be the person doing the service. But I realized it wasn't passive income. I realized that I needed to get somebody else to do it, and that essentially would create passive income for myself. So that's why, for example, for this is from a product that I did not have to create. I don't have to do customer service. I don't have to do order fulfillment. I don't have to actually give the value because there's someone who's already doing that for me. And my passive income is literally getting myself out of the process by literally outsourcing all those. So for example, creating traffic, how do I outsource that? I know there's millions of people that go on YouTube and Pinterest. I don't have to find them actually myself. I don't have to cold call people. That's gonna take time away from me, okay? It's creating leverage because millions of people can literally see the content that's very cheap for me to make, okay? How do I capture leads, right? It's simple. You just grab their email just by creating a website and a blog. We have a free 5-day bootcamp in the link below. The third one is how do I convert a sale? I can either start writing emails about stories and whatnot, or I could partner with people where they're gonna write all the emails for me. And you can see that some of these people have affiliate pages where they're gonna give you all the emails to write. And how do I actually go ahead and, for example, convert the sale? It's pretty simple. Sometimes they will actually do the selling for you. This is literally what I did for some of my biggest launches is I was like, okay, I could just partner with an expert if I'm bad at selling and they'll do the selling for me. And that's how I could leverage their expertise to make passive income. And the more I started doing that, that's how all this started really growing, guys. And I'm not the smartest person in the world. If I can do this, why can't you? Of course, if you want an even faster and easier way to make money online and passive income online, then sign up for this week's free workshop because we have a 62-year-old woman go from zero to $160,000 profit in 90 days, as well as check out my podcast of all these multimillionaires that literally live here in Bali. Check it out here and here. Hopefully this helps. Love you guys. See you guys later.